If you've ever wondered what it's like to be a B-52 bomber pilot, today we're gonna find out. My buddy Cougar, he's a major in the United States Air Force. So Cougar, how long have you been flying the B-52?
See, I've been flying it about 4.5 years. Been in the Air Force for about 10. I was a T-6 instructor pilot before that. Did that for about 3 years before I started flying the B-52. So this is a B-52H. These are the only models we're currently flying in the Air Force right now. They did have, you know, A through G before this, but this is the only model we're currently flying. All the rest of them are cut up in the desert somewhere. It's a nose radome right here. We do have a ground mapping radar that we use to update our navigation system. And this puppy right here is a forward-looking infrared. It helps us find the tanker at night or in kind of bad weather.
Oh, well, so that helps you just see during the night.
Exactly.
It's like a night vision camera. All right, Cougar, show me where this thing drops its bombs from.
All right, let's take a look.
All right, so in the bomb bay here, how many bombs does this bomb bay hold?
We can actually carry 27 500 or 750-pound bombs, and they mount on cluster racks. We'll put 3 of them and 9 on each.
Wow, 27?
27.
Wow.
Carry another 18 out on the wings for a grand total of 45.
So 45 bombs total.
That's it.
I see a little door up there in the right-hand corner. What is that for?
So if for some reason we drop a bomb and we don't know if it actually came off the airplane, we actually send the youngest guy out to, or smallest guy out here, to actually come in and visually inspect the bomb bay.
So the lowest guy in the totem pole, if there's a mishap with your bomb not dropping out of this thing, has to crawl through the airplane through those little doors, huh?
Exactly.
Wow.
He has to come back here with the flashlight and make sure that it actually came off the airplane. If it didn't, then we have a procedure to get rid of it.
Man, Cougar, I'm gonna tell you right now, the landing gear on this airplane is massive. What is it like to land in crosswinds with this thing?
So we have tip gear, and we don't actually crab into the wind and land in a crab. We have a system that we can use to calculate how much crosswind component we use, and a knob in between the pilot and the co-pilot seat where we actually physically move the tires so that they're aligned with the runway.
So there's no rudder control when you're coming in crosswinds? It's just done with the dial, and the gear actually turns?
The gear actually turns.
Wow.
And we land in a crab.
That's pretty cool.
So you can be flying down the runway. You know, the runway's right here and you're pointed 10, 20 degrees off from it. So every pilot in the Air Force goes through pilot training, and everyone starts off in the T-6. And then depending on what they want to fly, they go to either the T-38 or the T-1. Or if they want to fly helicopters, they got a Huey down at Fort Rucker in Alabama.
So is it pretty hard to get used to flying such a big airplane?
It can be a little bit weird, but you get used to it, believe it or not.
The one thing I don't see is, how do you get up into the airplane?
So there's no door on the side. We actually use a crew entry hatch, and it's actually underneath the airplane.
Oh, show us let's go up in this thing.
All right.
All right, guys, to get up into this B-52, it's right in the belly, and it's pretty tight. I guess, where are we going the first stage here? What compartment is this?
This is the offense compartment. Two people sit down here, the radar navigator and the navigator, and their job is to work together to make sure we can get weapons off the airplane. Everything that has to do with weapons starts and ends down here.
This is where it all happens.
This is where it all happens.
With the weapons. And there is no windows down here, so they don't have much of a view.
No, not at all. They get a green screen view of the world.
Yeah, interesting.
So this is how they control the pod, and if the airplane had a pod, then it would have another screen up here, and they can use that pod to generate target coordinates and all kinds of cool stuff, shoot a laser at things and guide weapons into it, and the radar nav is responsible for that.
All right, to continue on in the B-52 here, so we came up through the bottom hatch there. This is where the weapons room is that we call it?
Offense compartment.
Okay, that's where they sit to do all the weapons stuff. And now you continue up this ladder, and now we're gonna go up to where all the magic happens.
That's it.
Wow. So this is your office right up here.
It is.
It's a little low overhead. You gotta make sure you're not too tall to get through here.
Yeah, for such a big airplane, there's not a lot of room.
All right, this is the cockpit of the B-52 Bomber.
This is it.
Wow. All right, Cougar, look at this. How many power levers do you have here? That's a lot of power levers.
Yeah, we have 8 engines, each with 17,000 pounds of thrust each. And about the only airplane in the world you can push up 8 throttles on takeoff.
Wow, that is like so awesome. So sitting up in this cockpit, you get it's a really good view out the windows. You sit really high, that's for sure.
You do, a really good view going out. I never complain about that.
How many different countries do you think you've flown to in this airplane?
Gosh, no telling.
All right, so yeah, you were telling us earlier that with the crosswind on this airplane, you just adjust the dial?
Exactly, this knob right here is actually rudder trim on the outside, and then the crosswind crab control is right here. You'll just calculate your crosswind crab on this handy dandy chart that we have here, lift up, twist it one way or the other, depending on what you calculate.
And then the gear will turn for to compensate for the crosswind landing.
Exactly.
So Cougar, one thing I see these little devices all around the cockpit up in the windows. What are those for?
It's a good question. Actually, those are for thermal curtains. And what we use those for is to blind out the cockpit so that during a nuke flash, it doesn't blind anybody.
Wow, so you pull those little bells and then like a curtain comes up on the windows?
Yeah, it comes all the way up and it'll cover every window we got in here.
All right, I fly Caravans and TBMs around currently, you know, with a single engine turboprop. But look at the instrument panel on this, guys. We have a set of gauges for each of the 8 engines. I guess when you do a takeoff power, normally I always look to make sure everything's looking good in the green. You just do a general good scan of the whole instrument panel, correct?
Exactly.
Since there's so many?
You look at basically a clock position to make sure everything is about where it should be. We use takeoff engine pressure ratio to set takeoff power, and that's the only one I really take a longer look at on takeoff.
All right. Then you got your landing gear down there, your landing gear handle, and then
landing gear handle.
This is your total fuel flow gauge. I guess that totals out all your engines?
Exactly.
And what does this burn for, what's your normal fuel flow rate on this?
So a good rough estimate is about 20,000 pounds per hour. And
that's
at cruise. You know, on takeoff with a heavy airplane, it can be as high as 60,000 pounds an hour.
So at takeoff, you could be burning 60,000 pounds of fuel per hour taking off. That's a lot of fuel.
We carry a lot of fuel, so.
How many gallons of fuel does this hold?
48,000 gallons, 312,000 if you fill all the tanks.
So the one thing else I noticed up here on the instrument panel is these two screens. Is that for you guys to watch Netflix?
I wish, Steve-O. We'd find some long missions and that would be a fun addition. But these are actually only one color. And it's a map display that shows up. Or that camera we looked at downstairs in the front of the airplane,
Okay. That's
where it'll display.
Oh, so that's what you can see what that camera is shooting at.
Exactly, for a low light, trying to find the tanker in the weather, or anything that shows up as a heat source.
Can you guys mid-air refuel with this?
Oh yeah, we mid-air refuel all the time.
All right, Cougar, thank you so much for bringing us on board the B-52 and showing us all around. It was really interesting to see everything. I know the viewers probably enjoyed it too. If you liked the video, please smash the thumbs up button. Also subscribe to the channel if you want to see more videos like this. Thanks for serving our country, Cougar. I really appreciate everything you do for us.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure. Who would believe you were a beauty indeed, when the days get shorter and the nights get